Now there's a trade you all know well, it's bringing cattle over. I'm gonna tell you about the time that I became a drover. I wanted stock for Queensland to Kempsey, I did wonder. I bought a bunch of duffers there and began as an overland. So pass the bottle round me, boys, don't you leave it stand there. For tonight we drink the health of every overlander. Well, when the cattle were counted and the outfit ready to start, the boys were all mounted with their swags up in the cart. I saw I had all kinds of men from Germany, France and Flanders, lawyers, doctors, good and bad, in the mob of overlanders. So pass the bottle round me, boys, don't you leave it stand there, for tonight we drink the health of every overlander. Now I would scorn to brig a shirt, as all me mates can say, but if we pass through a township all on a washing day, why the dirty brats of kids would shout and quickly raise me down to crying, mother, quick, bring in the clothes, here comes the overlander. So pass the bottle round me, boys, don't you leave it stand there, for tonight we drink the health of every overlander. In town we drain the whiskey flask and go to see the play. We never think of being hard up or how to spend the day. We shear up to them pretty girls who rig themselves with grandeur, and as long as you spend your checks, me lads, they love the overlanders. So pass the bottle round me, boys, don't you leave it stand there, for tonight we drink the health of every overlander. Oh, a little girl in Sydney town, she said, don't be lonely. I said, it's sad, but my old nag has room for one man only. So now I must be jogging on this pony, she's a goer. We'll pick up a job with a crawling mob along the Maranoa. So pass the bottle round me, boys, don't you leave it stand there, for tonight we drink the health of every overland. Swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, leaning on the water bottle. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Down came a jumbuck to drink from the billabong. Up jumped the swagman and he grabbed him with glee, and he sang as he stuffed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. Oh, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling. Waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, leaning on the water bottle. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Up rode the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Down came the troopers, one, two, three. Where's that jolly jumbuck you've got in your tucker bag? Oh, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, leaning on the water bottle. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Jumped the swagman and sprang into the billabong. Oh, you'll never catch me alive, said he, and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, Waltz and Matilda, leaning on the water bottle, you'll come a waltz and Matilda with me. I am a young man cut down in my blossom. I married a young girl to cheer up me home. But she goes out and leaves me and cruelly deceives me and leaves me with a wee one that's none of me own. Oh, dear, will the day ever I marry? Oh, how I wish I was single again. For this weeping and wailing and rocking the cradle and rocking the wee one that's none of me own. Now while I'm at work and me wife's on the rantin', she's rantin' and dancin' with some other young man. Well, she's drinkin' and swearin' while I'm at home carin' and rockin' the wee one that's none of me own. Oh, dear, will the day ever I marry? Oh, how I wish I was single again. For this weeping and wailing and rocking the cradle and rocking the wee one that's none of me own. Now all you young men with a mind for to marry, beware of them flash women, leave them alone. For by the Lord Harry, if one you should marry, she'll leave you with a wee one that's none of your own. Oh, dear, will the day ever I marry? Oh, how I wish I was single again. For this weeping and wailing and rocking the cradle and rocking the wee one that's none of me own.
Out from Rota when the sheds had all cut out, we'd whips and whips some money and we meant to push about. And we humped our blues serenely as we made for Sydney town, with a three-spot check between us that wanted knocking down. We camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai, the road to Gundagai, 5 miles from Boonabri. Yes, we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. Oh, we struck the Murrumbidgee near Nyanko in a week. And we passed through old Naganda and crossed the Barney Creek. And we never stopped at Wagga for we'd Sydney in our eye. But we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. Yes, we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. The road to Gundagai, 5 miles from Boonabri. Yes, we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. Well, I've seen lots of girls, me lads, and I've drunk a lot of beer. And I've met with some of both lads that have left me pretty queer. But for beer to knock you sideways and for girls to make you cry, you should camp at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. Camp at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. The road to Gundagai, 5 miles from Boonabri. You should camp at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. Well, we chucked our flaming swag down and walked into the bar and ordered rum and raspberry and a shilling each cigar. But the girl who served the poison, she winked at Bill and I. So we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. We camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. The road to Gundagai, 5 miles from Boonabri. Yes, we camped at Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. In a week the spree was over and the check was all knocked down. So we shouldered our Matildas and turned our backs on town. And the girl stood us a nobbler as we sadly said goodbye. And we tramped from Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. We tramped from Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. The road to Gundagai, 5 miles from Boonabri. Yes, we tramped from Lazy Harry's on the road to Gundagai. A sad story I'll tell, if you'll listen to me, about two fellas who couldn't agree. What one called white, the other called black, they'd argue a while, then they'd step out the back and it's on. All reason and logic is gone. Winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. Well, they'd come back inside again, then the argument would become heated again. Who won the last round, they could never decide, till one asked the other, would he please step outside, and it's on. All reason and logic is gone. Winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. They've been fighting so long, they can hardly recall what in the first place had started at all. But they keep fighting on, day in and day out. Now they're fighting to see what they're fighting about, and it's on. All reason and logic is gone. Winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. Now can you imagine if intellectuals came to agreement by Queensbury's rules? Could it easily be argued that the square root of 4 was 15 less 3 plus a smash on the jaw, and it's on. All reason and logic is gone. Winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. Now if governments think that it makes better sense to save on education and spend on defense, could easily be argued upon the same grounds. Elections should be the best of 10 rounds, and it's on. All reason and logic is gone. Winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. Yes, winning the fight won't prove that you're right. It's sad, it's true, but it's on. In South Australia I was born. Heave away, haul away. In South Australia, round Cape Horn, for we're bound for South Australia. Heave away, your rolling king. Heave away, haul away. Heave away, oh hear me sing, for we're bound for South Australia. There's only one thing grieves me mind, heave away, haul away, that's leaving Nancy Blair behind, for we're bound for South Australia. Heave away, your rolling king, heave away, haul away, heave away, oh hear me sing, for we're bound for South Australia. I run her all night and I run her all day. Heave away, haul away. Well, I run her until we sail that day, for we're bound for South Australia. Heave away, your rolling king. Heave away, haul away. Heave away, oh hear me sing, for we're bound for South Australia. I wish I was on Australian shores. Heave away, haul away, with a bottle of whiskey in me paw, for we're bound for South Australia. Heave away, your rolling king. Heave away, haul away. Heave away, oh hear me sing, for we're bound for South Australia. Business section where four bush roads cross and meet. It stands in quite a neat location to rest the weary traveller's feet. Kerosene lamps are burning brightly, cards and lull the billiard balls. Men and maids are dancing lightly to the music in the halls. Rolls a bottle standing upright, labelled with bright blue and gold. Beer so cold it needs no ice, and from the cellar's dear dark hole. There's quoits and games and bagtail, all to suit your fancy, oh. But better far behind the bar stand smiling, darling Nancy, oh. Well, Nancy smiles are quite bewitching, to have some fun she's willing, oh. You give her a rap, she turns the tap and thanks you for your shilling, oh. Oh, rose a bottle standing upright, labelled with bright blue and gold. Beer so cold it needs no ice, and from the cellar's dear dark hole. Landlord shouting is uncommon, he's kidding you to dance and play. Oh, how the devil can men keep sober and no shanties by the way. Oh, rose a bottle standing upright, labelled with bright blue and gold. Beer so cold it needs no ice, and from the cellar's dear dark hole. I dreamt I shot in a shearing shed, and it was a dream of joy. For every one of them rouseabouts was a girl dressed up like a boy. Dressed up like a page in a pantomime, all the prettiest ever I've seen. They had coal black hair, they had flaxen hair, and every shade in between. But there was tall, thin girls, there was short, fat girls, prettiest ever I've seen. They was 4'5", they was 6 foot high, and every shape in between. Now Now the sheds was cooled by electric fans that hung over every chute. The pens were polished mahogany and everything else to suit. And the huts had springs to the mattresses, and the tucker was something grand. And every night by a billabong we danced to a German band. But there was tall, thin girls, there was short, fat girls, prettiest ever I've seen. They was 4 foot five, they was 6 foot high, and every shade in between. Now our pay was the wool off the jumbox back, so we shore them till they was blue. The sheep was shampooed before they was shorn, and the rams was perfumed too. And all of us cried when the sheds cut out, despite them long hot days. For every hour them girls waltzed in with whiskey and beer on trays. But there was tall, thin girls, there was short, fat girls, prettiest ever I've seen. They was 4 foot five, they was 6 foot high, and every shape in between. There was three of them girls to every chap, and as jealous as they could be. There was three of them girls to every chap, and six of them picked on me. We was passing them round for the homeward run, and sharing them out like steam. When I woke with me head in the blazing sun, to find it a shearer's dream. But there was tall, thin girls, there was short, fat girls, prettiest ever I've seen. They was 4 foot five, they was 6 foot high, and every shape in between. I'm a stockman to me trade, and they calls me Ugly Dave. I'm old and grey and I've only got one eye. In the yard I'm good of course, but just put me on the horse and I'll go where lots of young'uns dare and try. I've led them through the gidgy, over country rough and ridgy. I've lost them in the very worst of scrub. I can ride both rough and easy, and with the dewdrop I'm a daisy, and I'm a ride down Bobby Dazzler in a pub. Oh, just watch me with the whip, I can make the Dawdlers skip, I can make the flaming echoes roar and ring. And with the brand and iron, well, I'm just a perfect flaming swell. Well, in fact, I'm Duke of every blasted thing. Oh, to see me skin a sheep, it's so pretty you could weep. And I can act the silver tail just like me blood was blue. Oh, you could strike me pink or dead if you stood me on me head. I'd be just as good as any other two. I've a notion in me pate that it's luck it isn't fate that I'm so far above the common run. Well, for everything I do, you can split me fair in two, for I'm much too flaming good to be in one. Now there once was this shearer by the name Louis Brink,
A devil for work and a devil for drink. He could share his 200 each day without fear. He could drink without winking 4 gallons of beer. Now Jimmy the barman, what served up the drinks, hated the sight of this here bluey brink. Well, he stayed much too late and he came much too soon, each morning, each evening, each night and at noon. Now one day while Jimmy was cleaning the bar, with sulfuric acid he kept in a jar, while along came the shitter with a terrible thirst. Said, whatever you got, Jimmy, give me the first. Now it ain't down in the histories, it ain't down in the prints, but that shitter drank acid with never a wink, saying, this is the stuff, Jimmy knocked me stone dead. I'll be the best shearer in Stevenson Sheds. And all that day long as he pulled out the beer, Jimmy was shaken with his troubles and fears, too anxious to argue, too troubled to fight, seeing that shearer a corpse in its flight. But the next day while Jimmy was opening the bar, along came the shearer craving for more, with his eyebrows all singed and his whiskers deranged, and holes in his eye like a dog with the mange. Well, says Jimmy to Bluey, and how's the new stuff? Said Bluey, 'twas fine, but I ain't had enough. Well, it gives me great courage to shear and to fight, but why does this stuff set me whiskers alight? Well, I thought I knew drink, but I must have been wrong. The stuff you give me, it's proper and strong. Well, it sets me to coughing, and you know I'm no liar, and every cough sets me whiskers on fire.
Oh, hark, the dogs are barking. I can no longer stay. The men have all gone mustering, and it is nearly day. And I must be off in the morning, love, before the sun does shine, to meet the Sydney shearer on the banks of the Condamine. Oh, Willie, dearest Willie, oh, let me go with you. I'll cut off all of me auburn fringe, and I'll be a shearer too, and I'll help you count your tally, love, while ringed eyes shine, and I'll wash your greasy moleskins on the banks of the Condamine. Oh, Nancy, dearest Nancy, you know you cannot go. The boss has given his orders, love, no woman shall do so. And your delicate constitution isn't equal on to mine, to stand at constant tiger and on the banks of the Condamine. Oh, Willie, dearest Willie, then stay at home with me. We'll take up a selection, love and a farmer's wife I'll be. And I'll help you husk the corn, me love, and I'll cook your meals so fine. You'll forget that ram stack mutton on the banks of the Condamine. Oh, Nancy, dearest Nancy, you know I cannot stay. The men have all gone muster, and I heard the publican say, so here's a goodbye kiss, me love, till homeward I'll incline. When we've shone the last of the jumbucks on the banks of the Condamine.
All you gallant bush rangers who gallop on the plains, who refuse to live in slavery or wear the convict chains. Oh, attention pay to what I say, and value it if you do, for I will relate the matchless fate of bold Jack Donahue. Now Donahue was taken all for a notorious crime, and sentenced to be hanged on a gallows tree so high. But when they took him to Bathurst jail, why, left them in the stew. Oh, and they came to call the roll, why, they missed Jack Donahue. Now when Donahue made his escape through the bush, he went straightway. The squatters, they were all afraid to travel be night and be day. And every day in the newspapers, they brought out something new, concerning that old bush ranger that they called Jack Donahue. One day as he was riding the mountainside along, a-listening to the cock-a-bar's happy laughing song, and all he spied the horse police, well, arm came up into view, and in double quick time they did advance to take Jack Donahue. Oh, Donahue, oh, Donahue, throw down your carabines. Or do you intend to fight us all, or will you not resign to surrender to such cowardly dogs as the thing I never would do? All this day I'll fight with all of me might, cried bold Jack Donahue. Well, the sergeant and the corporal, their men, they did divide. Some fired at him from behind, and some from every side. Oh, the sergeant and the corporal, they both fired at him too, and a rifle bullet pierced the heart of old Jack Donahue. Well, nine rounds he'd fired, and nine men down before that fatal ball that pierced his heart and made him smart and caused him far to fall. And as he closed his mournful eyes, why, he bid the world adieu, saying, convicts all, pray for the soul of Bulger.